फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटीज। आई एम स्टार्टिंग विथ क्वेश्चन नंबर 32, कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। एंड व्हाट डू वी राइट इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटीज? व्हाट मेनली वी नीड टू कंसीडर, दैट इज नॉन करेंट लाइबिलिटीज एंड शेयर होल्डर फंड। इज दैट क्लियर? For the simplification, remember in this manner that shareholder fund and non-current liabilities are recorded under financing activities. From the following information, calculate cash flow from financing activities. Long-term loan, opening balance and closing balance is given, and during the year, company repaid a loan of rupees 1 lakh. So children, when opening and closing balance is given and something is given in the adjustment also, na? So it is better to prepare loan account. So let me prepare. Question number 32. Long term loan account. Okay. Debit side, credit side, loan account starts from credit side. So we write opening balance by balance brought down. What is opening balance? You can see opening balance is 2 lakh. So closing balance comes in debit side. 2 balance carried down. Let's see what is closing balance. So closing balance is given 2,50,000. 2,50,000, and here it is mentioned that during the year company repaid a loan of rupees 1 lakh. So company repaid a loan, it means to bank 1 lakh rupees, isn't it or not? So let's do the total, which side is bigger. 250 plus 1 lakh, 3,50,000. Debit side is more. It means balance is remaining in credit side. How much balance is remaining? 1,50,000. If balance is remaining in credit side, what does it mean? It means company has raised more loan. So by bank, isn't it or not? So company has raised 1,50,000 loan. So now we need to prepare cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activities. Okay, so you can see here how much loan has been raised. 1,50,000 long term loan raised, 1,50,000. So it will be inflow of cash. And how much loan has been repaid? 1 lakh rupees loan has been repaid. So repayment of long term loan, repayment of long term loan, that is 1 lakh. Repayment of long term loan means outflow of cash. So the total will be 50,000 positive balance. It means this is known as cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. I hope it is clear to everyone. Hai na? Yes. From the following information, calculate cash flow from financing activities. Current year and previous year are given. Equity share capital, security premium reserve, 12% debentures are given. Interest paid on debentures, 18,000 is given. So let's prepare cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activities. So let's begin. Equity share capital, earlier it was 9 lakh, now it is 10 lakh. What does it mean? It means issue of share capital. So issue of equity share capital. Issue of equity share capital. 1 lakh. Inflow of cash. Then security premium reserve. When we issue share capital, at that time we take some money more than face value, that is known as security premium reserve. So earlier security premium reserve was 2,50,000, now it is 2,60,000. It means 10,000 is taken more when share capital is issued. So security premium reserve 10,000. Security premium reserve 10,000. It is capital received, children. SPR is also known as capital received. Then 12% debentures. Earlier debentures were of 1,50,000. Now we have only 1 lakh rupees. What does it mean? It means we have repaid debentures of rupees 50,000. So redemption of debentures, 50,000. Redemption of 12% debentures 50,000, result in outflow of cash. Okay. And then in additional information, it is mentioned that interest paid on debentures 18,000. So interest paid on debentures is also financing activity. Interest paid on debentures 18,000 is financing activity, result in outflow of cash. Let's do the total. So 1,10,000 minus 68,000 is equal to 42,000. Positive value, it means it is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. I hope it is clear to everyone. Question number 34. From the following extracts of the balance sheet of EXE Limited, calculate cash flow from financing activities. So current year and previous year are given. Equity share capital, preference share capital, security premium reserve, debentures. Additional informations are given. Equity shares were issued on 31st March 2021. Okay. Interim dividend on equity share was paid 15%. Okay. Preference shares were redeemed on 31st March 2021 at a premium of 5%. Fine. Premium paid was debited to statement of profit and loss. 12% debentures of face value of Rs. 1 lakh were issued on 31st March 2020. Prepare cash flow from financing activity. All transactions are related to financing activity. So let's begin. Question number 34. Very good question. Cash flow from financing activities. Okay, so you can see here equity share capital, earlier it was 4 lakh, now it is 5,25,000. It means it is increased by 1,25,000. It means equity share capital issued. Issue of equity share capital. Equity share capital 1,25,000. Then we can see security premium reserve is also given. Dear children? So security premium reserve is also increased by 1,25,000. 1,25,000 means 1,25,000. It means it is also increased by 1,25,000. Security premium reserve. 1,25,000. Then you can see preference share capital. Earlier it was 5,50,000. Now it is 4,00,000. What does it mean? It means we repaid the preference share capital. That is known as redemption of share capital. So it is 1,50,000 redemption of 10% preference share capital. Redemption of 10% preference share capital. That is 1,50,000. Repaid means outflow, है ना? So 1,50,000 552.4. Now 12% debentures, non-current liability. Earlier it was 3,00,000. Now it is 4,00,000. It means we have issued debentures of rupees 1,00,000. Issue of debentures. Issue of 12% debentures of rupees 1,00,000. Okay, some additional informations are given. Equity shares were issued on 31st March. It means 1,25,000 we issued on 31st March. Interim dividend on equity share was paid 15%. Interim dividend, it is paid on the opening values. So for 15% of 4,00,000, 15% of equity share capital, but we take opening value, na? So 15% of 4,00,000 is 60,000 interim dividend paid. Interim dividend, 15% of 4,00,000. That will be 60,000. It is paid, so outflow, 60,000 outflow. Anna? Then preference shares were redeemed on 31st March. Redeemed means, redemption means payment on 31st March. So earlier it was 550, now it is 4,00,000, means 1,50,000 is repaid. How much is repaid? 150 is repaid at a premium of 5%. It means we need to pay 5% premium of 1,50,000. Okay, so premium on redemption of preference share. So how much preference shares we have redeemed? It is mentioned here 1,50,000. So 5% of 1,50,000, 7,500. Yes or no? So 7,500 is repaid as a premium on redemption of preference share. Then here it is mentioned 12% debentures of face value 1,00,000 were issued on 31st March. See, debentures, come on, debentures. Debentures were issued on 31st March. It means whole year we have debentures of rupees 3,00,000. So we need to pay interest only of rupees 3,00,000. 12% is the rate. So interest on debenture. Interest on debentures. 12% of how much debentures opening? In opening, debentures were of 3,00,000 rupees. 12% of 3,00,000. 36 means 36,000. Interest on debenture paid. It means outflow of cash. 36,000. Okay. Then here it is mentioned that interim dividend on equity share was paid. Children, I think everybody know that equity share holder get dividend afterwards. First who get? First get preference shareholder. That is what the name of this share capital is, preference. This is what they have right, preferential right over the equity share capital. If it is mentioned that equity shareholder is getting dividend, if it is written here that equity shareholder is getting dividend, what does it mean? It means preference shareholder received first. So we need to give dividend to preference shareholder also. So the rate of preference shareholder is 10% and the opening value is 5,50,000, isn't it? So 10% of 5,50,000 is 55,000. So dividend ऑफ 10% प्रिफरेंस शेयर, सॉरी दैट इज 55,000, 5,50,000 ओपनिंग वैल्यू, 10% 55,000. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू एवरी वन, इजंट इट? हाँ, लेट्स डू द टोटल, ऑल पॉइंट्स आर ओवर, लेट मी डू द टोटल. लैक 50,000 माइनस 1,50,000 प्लस 1,00,000 माइनस 67,500 माइनस 36,000 माइनस 55,000 इट इज कमिंग पॉजिटिव 41,500. इट मीन्स दिस इज कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू एवरी वन. ओके, लेट्स बिगिन क्वेश्चन नंबर 35. फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन कैलकुलेट कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम इन्वेस्टिंग एंड फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटीज. इन दिस क्वेश्चन इन्वेस्टिंग एंड फाइनेंसिंग बोथ आर टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड. ओके, लेट अस डू मशीनरी करेंट ईयर एंड प्रीवियस ईयर वैल्यूज आर गिवन. मशीनरी एट कॉस्ट, एक्यूमुलेटेड डेब्ट, कैपिटल एंड बैंक लोन. ड्यूरिंग द ईयर अ मशीन कॉस्टिंग 10,000 वॉज सोल्ड एट अ लॉस ऑफ 2,000. डेप्रिसिएशन ऑन मशीनरी चार्ज ड्यूरिंग द ईयर इज 6,000. सो चिल्ड्रन, फर्स्ट आई विल प्रिपेयर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, है ना. एक्यूमुलेटेड डेब्ट ओपनिंग क्लोजिंग बैलेंस इज गिवन. सो फर्स्ट आई विल प्रिपेयर एक्यूमुलेटेड डेब्ट अकाउंट, है ना. सम वर्किंग नोट्स वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर. वर्किंग नोट नंबर 1, एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट. दिस इज वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस बुक, दिस चैप्टर. प्लीज मार्क, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, है ना. डेबिट साइड, क्रेडिट साइड. सो एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्ट ओपनिंग बैलेंस इज गिवन 10,000 बाय बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन 10,000 एंड क्लोजिंग बैलेंस विल कम इन डेबिट साइड टू बैलेंस कैरिड डाउन. हाउ मच इट इज गिवन? इट इज गिवन 12,000. Now children, in the question it is mentioned that depreciation on machinery charged during the year 6,000. It means it is current year depreciation, है ना. So by statement of profit and loss, how much? 6,000. So now where balance is remaining? Let's do the total. 10 plus 6, 16,000. 16 minus 12, 4,000. So balance is remaining in debit side. If balance is remaining in debit side, what does it mean? To machine. This is the total depreciation. Total depreciation of machine which has been sold. Of sold asset, hai na? Of sold machine. Total depreciation of sold machine is 4,000. Now see, dear children, according to question, a machine costing 10,000. What is the cost of machine? 10,000. And what is the accumulated debt of that machine? 4,000. Minus accumulated debt, we have computed here. 4,000. So 10 minus 4. Now what is the book value of machine? Now the book value of machine is 6,000. Sold at a loss of rupees 2,000. If it is sold at a loss of 2,000, at what price it has been sold? At what price it has been sold? It means it is sold for रुपीज 4,000। वर्किंग नोट नंबर टू, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है ना, सो दिस इज वेरी मच रिक्वायर्ड व्हेन वी प्रिपेयर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी एंड देन वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर मशीन अकाउंट। ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग बैलेंस ऑफ मशीन इज गिवन। लेट मी प्रिपेयर वर्किंग नोट नंबर थ्री, मशीन अकाउंट। डेबिट साइड, क्रेडिट साइड। मशीन अकाउंट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम डेबिट साइड, सो टू बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन। ओपनिंग बैलेंस 40,000, क्लोजिंग बैलेंस विल कम इन क्रेडिट साइड बाय बैलेंस कैरिड डाउन। क्लोजिंग बैलेंस इज गिवन 50,000। ओके एंड देन लेट्स कम हियर, एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप ऑफ दैट मशीन इज 4,000। इट इज वी हैव कंप्यूटेड हियर है ना, सो बाय एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट 4,000। यू कैन सी इट इज रिटन इन द डेबिट साइड मशीन टू मशीन 4,000 इन एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप अकाउंट, सो हियर इट विल कम इन मशीन अकाउंट बाय एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप 4,000 इन दिस मैनर है ना। Okay, now it is sold for 4,000 by bank. It is mentioned here by bank 4,000 and it is sold at a loss of rupees 2,000. It is mentioned here. So by statement of profit and loss, this is the loss 2,000 rupees. Is that clear? है ना, लेट्स डू द टोटल 60,000 माइनस 40,000, बैलेंस इज रिमेनिंग इन द डेबिट साइड दैट इज 20,000। इफ बैलेंस इज रिमेनिंग इन डेबिट साइड ऑफ मशीन अकाउंट व्हाट डज इट कॉल टू बैंक, इट मीन्स दिस इज परचेज purchase of machine which is very much required when we prepare investing activity. Now I think we can prepare investing activity, so let's prepare cash flow from investing activity. Cash flow from investing activity. In investing activity what do we write? In investing activity we write non-current assets and non-current investment. So what is given here in this question? Purchase of machine 20,000 according to question. Purchase of machine is given 20,000. Then sale of machine is also given here 4,000. Sale of machine, purchase of machine is outflow hai na, so we should put bracket 20,000. Sale of machine 4,000, that is inflow of cash. Nothing is given other than these two point hai na, so let's do the total. So 16,000 negative value will come, it means cash used in investing activity. I hope it is clear. Cash flow from investing activity. One more activity we need to prepare, that is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. Okay, so let's prepare cash flow from financing activity also. What do we write in financing activity? Everybody know, shareholder fund plus non-current liability, isn't it? So let's check in the question what is given. Capital is given 30 to 35, it means it is increasing, so we can say issue of share capital 5,000. देन बैंक लोन, अर्लियर इट वॉज 10,000, नाउ इट इज निल, इट मीन्स रीपेमेंट ऑफ बैंक लोन 10,000. Repayment of bank loan is 10,000. All points are over. Yes, nothing is there. So 5 minus 10 minus 5. Negative value, it means it is cash used in invest financing activity. Okay, dear children. I hope the investing activity and financing activity is clear to everyone. For financing activity. Question number 37. Jalco Limited provided the following information. Calculate net cash flow from financing activities. Ready. Hai na? So equity share capital is given. Current year, previous year, 10 to 12 lakh. 12% debentures are given, 1 lakh to 2 lakh. Additional information, interest paid on debenture 19, dividend paid in the year 50,000. During the year, Jalco Limited issued bonus share in the ratio 5:1 by capitalizing reserve. So let's begin, dear children. Cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activities. Okay. So issue of equity share capital 10 to 12 means 2 lakh rupees. But dear children, here it is mentioned that company issued bonus share in the ratio 5:1. So 5:1. So children, you can pay attention here. For every 5 share, 1 bonus share is issued. For every 5 share, 1 bonus share is issued. So for 10 lakh rupees, share of rupees 10 lakh, how much bonus is given? Can you calculate? Let us calculate by cross multiplication. So 10 lakh divided by 5 lakh, 2 lakh. And 10 plus 2 lakh is equal to 12 lakh. It means the equity share capital which is raised from 10 to 12, it is because of issue of bonus share. And bonus share are issued by capitalizing reserve. It means they have taken money from their reserve. They have transferred money from reserve to the capital. The money is not taken from the shareholder. Money is not taken from the shareholder. Bonus shares are issued to them and reserves are used for that purpose. Is that clear? It means this is not raise of capital. Bonus share, by issuing bonus share, company do not receive any money. So there is no cash inflow. So this is not any cash transaction. This is not a cash transaction. So maybe equity share capital is increasing from 10 lakh to 12 lakh. But it is because of issue of bonus share by capitalizing reserve. So this is not a cash transaction. So it will not come. This is one reason, very important point in this question. Remember. And second, debentures. Earlier debentures were of rupees 1 lakh. Now debentures are of rupees 2 lakh. It means we have issued debentures of rupees 1 lakh. Issue of debentures. Rupees 1 lakh. It means this is inflow of cash. Then interest paid on debentures 19,000. Interest paid on debentures 19,000. interest paid means cash outflow. There is one more thing everybody must know, that 12% rate is given, है ना? So according to 12% rate, it should be 1 lakh or into 12%, 12,000. When this 1 lakh is issued, it is not given. So when in adjustment, it is mentioned the interest paid on debentures like this, then we overlook this 12%, and we ignore this 12% because it is clearly mentioned how much is paid. So cash payment is important for us in preparing of cash flow statement. Dividend paid in the year 50,000. Dividend paid 50,000. Okay, this point is also over. So all points are over. Let me do the total. 1 lakh minus 50, 50,000, 50 minus 10, 40 minus 9, 31,000. Positive, it means it is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children, is it clear?